Excellency, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I would like to express my sincere thanks to the organizer for an invitation extended to me to join this meaningful seminar. My thanks also for providing me the opportunity to speak here today. On this note, I would like to highlight the following key points in the relation between Laos and India in our seminar today. On the political area, I'm delighted to observe that during the past more than five decades of the friendly relations and cooperation between Laos and India have been fruitfully and steadily expanded at the highest level. Lao PDR and the Republic of India established diplomatic relations on the 2nd of February 1956. The two countries have long-standing traditional ties and good cooperation born in culture and religion. Our two countries have laid a solid foundation for our future direction of cooperation both in political and economic spheres. I would like to mention back to 2011 when our two countries celebrated the 55th anniversary of the establishment of diplomatic relations. Our two countries did many significant activities together. Since the 6th Joint Commission between the two countries, the friendly relationship and additional cooperation between Lao, PDR and India have continuously expanded. The exchange of visits at all levels between our two countries have been regularly continued, especially the state visit to the Lao PDR by Her Excellency Pratibha Nivasim Patil, President of the Republic of India in 2010. In December 2012, His Excellency Thongsin Thammavong, Prime Minister of the Lao PDR, visited India and to attend and attended the celebration of the 20th anniversary of ASEAN-India Summit. The visit and attending the 9th ASEAN Summit by His Excellency Salman Khurshid, Prime Minister of External Affairs of the Republic of India in 2012, and to chair the 7th Joint Commission meeting for bilateral cooperation between the Lao PDR and India in Vientiane, September 2013. The visit and attending the 6th Mekong Gonga cooperation meeting by His Excellency Thonglun Sisulit, Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of Foreign Affairs of the Lao PDR in Delhi in September 2012. The exchange visit have significantly contributed to further strengthening the traditional of relationship and cooperative solidarity between our two countries. I would like to highlight some important fact that since 1994, our two countries have signed many cooperation agreements which led to the implementation of many successful and effective projects in various fields which significantly contribute to the socio-economic development of our country. The two countries also concluded an agreement on visa exemption for holder of diplomatic and service passport in order to ease the exchange visit among officials of both countries. On the social and cultural cooperation, I would like to note that the government and the people of the Lao PDR highly value the assistance and support provided by the government and the people of the Republic of India to the Lao PDR in various fields, especially in the field of human resource development. The government of India provides scholarship for short and long-term training for Lao officials, about 200 people each year, and the number being increased. The scholarship that were provided to the Lao PDR, namely under the Indian Technical and Economic Programs, Special Commonwealth Assistance for African Program, and Civilian Training Program of the Colombo Plan. We also have very good cooperation in the field of preserving and protecting the cultural heritage. The Indian government helped set up a project to restore the Wat Phu Champasak, and now some countries are much interested in helping the world. The cultural performances between the Ministry of Culture of our two countries have been regularly exchanged. In the year to come, both countries will work closely together to promote more people-to-people exchange. On the economic investment and trade cooperation, I am satisfied to see that the economic cooperation between our two countries have been expanded. Nevertheless, if we look at our ability, there remains vast potential to be explored. In this regard, I would like to express my sincere thanks and appreciation to appreciation and support to the Lao Chambers, Lao National Chamber of Commerce and Industry, and of course the INCHAM, who tirelessly have spent efforts to promote the economic cooperation between our two countries. I do believe that this kind of seminar could help to promote better understanding and help to find opportunities to do business in the Lao PDR. I would like to note that the government of India also supports the promotion of small and medium enterprises. Apart from the ongoing loan project, the Lao government has proposed more new project proposal to the government of India for consideration. I do hope that in the near future, there will be more projects implemented in the Lao PDR supported by the government of India. For the trade and investment, I understand that today we have our colleagues and a representative from the Ministry of Industry and Commerce and a colleague from the Ministry of Planning and Investment who can share more detailed information with us today. I believe that this seminar today will produce a successful outcome that can help expanding business between our two countries. I once again thank you very much for the invitation. May I wish all participants in this meeting all the best of luck, the best of health, and great success in all of your undertaking. Thank you very much.